Although Windows Azure Mobile Services can be used for authentication, as we have seen, it works only against fixed set of identity providers as of today. We can also use other identity providers like Azure Access Control Services, and the recommended control to navigate to Access Control Service for authentication is Web Authentication Broker. Web Authentication Broker is a control that developers can embed for login functionality. It cannot be used as a general purpose browser control, and it is designed for login functionality in such a way that it keeps your cookies secure as well as clears them out of the box. At present, it works with OAuth out of the box, and we also have easy to use APIs available to interact with Web Authentication Broker. After a user is authenticated against an identity provider using Web Authentication Broker, these APIs can be used to extract user details or the token for further access to resources. Not only this, Web Authentication Broker has also got a customizable UI and is divided into different panes which you can customize. Let's see how claims authentication works with Windows Azure Access Control Service and Web Authentication Broker in Windows Store applications. Access Control Service is similar to Azure Mobile Services, which can authenticate users against online providers like Yahoo, Google, Facebook, and Microsoft account. Azure Access Control Service can also be configured to be used with third-party identity providers like ADFS or even your own custom STS. In the slide, we can see that there is a custom STS. The role of this custom STS is to extract the token from Azure Access Control Service and repackage in the format that Web Authentication Broker understands. There is also a trust created between Access Control Service and custom STS. This eliminates the need for Windows Store application to be registered in Access Control Service. Now let's have a look at the authentication. When a user launches a Windows Store application configured to use Access Control Service, Web Authentication Broker redirects the user to Access Control Service. Access Control Service shows a home realm discovery page where the user can specify the identity provider with which they wish to authenticate. Access Control Service then redirects the user to the selected identity provider, which could be Microsoft account, Facebook, Google, Yahoo, or a custom identity provider like ADFS, which can authenticate with your Enterprise Active Directory. After the identity provider authenticates the user, Access Control Service returns the token to your custom STS so that the token can be repackaged in a format that Web Authentication Broker understands. Custom STS repackages the token and sends it to Windows Store application. It can optionally send claims instead of entire token to Windows Store app. If we choose to send the token itself to Windows Store application, the Windows Store application can access further resources protected by Access Control Services. But if we don't wish to access any further resources and it is used just for authentication purpose, we can send just the claims. Let's see a demonstration of how we can configure Access Control Service, Windows Store application, and the custom STS to authenticate against online providers. In order to achieve this scenario or build this entire solution, we would need to build three components. Number one, a Windows Store application. Number two, configure Azure Access Control Service. And number three, a custom STS which repackages the token that Windows Store application and specifically Web Authentication Broker will understand. Let's create the custom STS which repackages the token first. In order to do that, I am creating an ASP.NET MVC website on one of my machines. In Visual Studio, create a new project and select ASP.NET MVC application. Let's call this as custom STS redirector. We don't wish to create a unit test. This custom STS that we have created, which is nothing but a simple ASP.NET MVC website, will be used to accept tokens from Access Control Service, repackage it, and in fact extract claims from it and send those claims to Windows Store application, which Web Authentication Broker will pick up. Now, ASP.NET MVC by default enables certain security features which does not allow to post any malicious code, and since the token that will be posted by access control service will be inside an HTTP form and we have to grab that token, we would disable the input validation. We can do it by adding an attribute on top of our default controller action. Let's turn off validate input. This will allow ASP.NET MVC to accept tokens from Azure Access Control Service without considering that as security risk. In order for this custom STS to be able to accept tokens, we need to register this custom STS on Azure Access Control Service portal. Before we do that, we would also enable this MVC website to be able to accept tokens by creating a trust between this website and Access Control Service. The trust is created two ways, in which we register this website to Access Control Service as well as register Access Control Service on this MVC website to be able to successfully validate the tokens. Let's go to Windows Azure Access Control Service portal so that we can get details about Access Control Service which we will add onto this custom STS. Let's open a browser and navigate to windows.azure.com. Sign into the portal. Once the portal loads, we can see on the left hand side menu Service Bus, Access Control and Caching. Let's select this and click on Access Control. If you're creating or using Windows Azure Access Control Service for the first time, you would not see Access Control and Caching as you're seeing here right now. And in that case, you will have to first create a new namespace and specify a namespace URI. Select the location. Select one of your subscription. Give a name, let's say 5678. Then you can create a namespace. I have already created that, so I will not create here. I'll use one of my existing namespaces, which is Rahul STS here, and go to Access Control Service. Sign in with your live ID. This is the landing page of Azure Access Control Service, and you can see on the left-hand side different options. One of the options that we are interested in is application integration. Under this section, we can get a URL which defines the capabilities of Azure Access Control Service. I can copy this URL, which would be needed when we register Access Control Service in our custom STS project. Let's go to our custom STS project. Now that we have grabbed the URL from Azure Access Control Service, I can right-click my project and select the option for Add STS Reference. You will not see this option if Windows Identity Foundation SDK is not installed. And the option in Visual Studio 2012 is not Add STS Reference, rather it is Identity and Access. This presents us with an option in the form of a wizard where we can enter different details and it will configure our application to start trusting tokens issued by Azure Access Control Service. One of the details that we need to fill in is application URI. This is the URI where your application would be found. In this case, this is the URI of my application which I will host in my local IIS. I know that I will give a URL with a virtual directory of name custom STS redirector, so I am typing this URL. It is important to know that we have to use HTTPS for security reasons. If it is a demo application, we can choose not to use HTTPS, but it is not recommended. Click on Next. And it asks whether you already have an STS or you want to create an STS. We have an STS, which is Azure Access Control Service, and I will paste the URL that we grabbed from Azure Access Control Service portal and move next. We will for now disable certificate chain validation because I'm using self-signed certificates. And we will also not encrypt token because we are already using SSL. And then finish the wizard. At the end, we should be able to see the successful message. Once we have completed the wizard, our application can start trusting the tokens issued by Access Control Service. And you can see few changes have been done. Number one, a federation metadata has been added in custom STS as well. And number two, in webconfig, some changes has been done specific to use claims authentication. We will not go into the details about these changes for now. Now, the job of this custom STS is to accept tokens from Azure Access Control Service, which we have already configured. The next thing that this custom STS has to do is to extract the claims about the user from the token and send it to Windows Store application. So I'll write a code snippet which will do that job. This is the code snippet that I have added. As you can see, there are certain errors, and those are there because we haven't added certain references. So we'll add the necessary references in our application. One of the references that we have to add is of system.identityModel, and another one for Microsoft.identityModel. The moment we do add these references, we can see that adding a using Microsoft.identityModel.claims namespace would resolve these references. Let's try to build the application and see if everything is fine. Seems fine. Now let's understand the code snippet as such. The first important thing that we will notice is that instead of returning any view, we are returning a redirect. What this means is that after the job is done, I am not displaying any user interface. Rather, I am redirecting the user to another URL, which is a standard HTTP 302 redirect. You can see that the URL that we are redirecting to is same that belongs to application. But actually speaking, there is no such URL that exists. And we have created this URL specifically so that this is actually not browsable. So you can see that the first part of the URL corresponds to the application itself, while the last portion makes this URL invalid because there is nothing called /n. The reason why we do this is when a token comes to this custom STS first of all extracts claims and puts in a variable. In this case, this is strClaims, and then redirect the user to another URL which has claims embedded as query string. And you can see that I'm adding this strClaims as a query string parameter to this URL. So whoever receives this entire URL would get the claims about the authenticated user. Now if you remember, web authentication broker in Windows Store application, when a user is redirected from Access Control Service to custom STS, all this redirection is happening within the web authentication broker of the user's Windows Store application. We can tell web authentication broker to always keep a watch on a fixed URL, and whenever that URL is used, web authentication broker should stop any further redirections and give the result back to the developer. That is the reason why I have created this invalid URL, and you can see later that I will configure web authentication broker to use the selected URL as a signal that whenever a user is redirected to this URL, you have to stop further processing and extract anything after this URL, which is ACS token. Now I'm extracting the details about the user from the token. The first two lines specify how you would get the authenticated user's token, and in the rest of the for each loop, we are enumerating over the claims of the authenticated user that we have received from Access Control Service and appending an STR claim. Any user claim is made of two parts, the type of claim as well as the value of claim. We are delimiting these using custom homegrown mechanism. For example, whenever a new claim starts, I use a word DEL, and between claim type and claim value for a single claim, I use a delimiter equals. Now we will publish this website to our IIS. In order to publish the website on IIS, I'll create a new application under my default website, store it somewhere in the standard locations. And then come back to the application and publish it. Now that we have published custom STS and also added access control service within this custom STS, we will also have to register this STS to Azure Access Control Service. So let's go to Azure Access Control Service portal. On Azure Access Control Service portal, let's come to identity providers first. You can see I have already added few identity providers, but when you come for the first time, you can add these out-of-the-box available identity providers or use WS Federation whenever you have to add any custom identity provider like ADFS 2.0. Then we'll come to relying party application and add our custom STS here. In order to add our custom STS, we would need the federation metadata of custom STS in ACS in the same way we added the federation metadata of ACS in custom STS. So I'll copy the location of this federation metadata and come to Azure portal, given friendly name, and I'll select an option to import WS Federation metadata from a file which is present locally. We'll keep other options as it is. I will turn off Active Directory for now and then click on Save. Once we have done that, we need to do one final thing, which is to configure rule groups. We just now added our custom STS and there is a default rule group that is created for custom STS. Rule groups define what information about the user which are authenticated should be passed to custom STS inside token. By default, no claims are passed about the user. So we will click on generate to generate the default claims and save it. So we have successfully created a custom STS that extracts the token from ACS and posts it to a URL that web authentication broker will understand, and then developer would get the claims. Now we would need to create a Windows Store application that will be able to use both these components of our entire solution. Now let's create a Windows Store application that will use access control service and the custom STS along with web authentication broker. We will not create an entire application from scratch. We will reuse the user interface of the Windows authentication sample. This is our Windows authentication sample. Let's modify the code to start using web authentication broker. We will comment out the code that we used to display information about Windows authenticated user and write our own custom code. So this is the code snippet that is used to perform authentication. On the button click, we first show the web authentication broker using the API, and you can see that it accepts three parameters. First parameter is used to specify the different kind of authentication methods it supports. If you want to use corporate network, you can use the option of corporate network, and you can use this option to authenticate against your internal Active Directory. While if you don't want to show any user interface, use silent mode. And if you want to implement single sign-on, where user can seamlessly move and also save cookie, similar to remember me kind of functionality, then use HTTP post. Right now, I'm using none, which means I'm not interested in any options of web authentication broker, just the plain functionality. First URL is the URL where user will be redirected. This is our custom STS that we created. And by virtue of the trust between custom STS and ACS, we can assume that when a user is redirected to this URL, user is further redirected to access control service for authentication. You can also replace this URL with access control service URL, wherein user will first go to access control service and then to STS, instead of going first to application, which is your custom STS, and then to access control service. Both are fine. The second URL is very important. This is not actually a URL, but a URI. If you remember, in custom STS, we specified this URI to post the token finally. And the second URL in Web Authentication Broker API tells Web Authentication Broker that whenever any entity in the entire ecosystem tries to redirect the user to this URL, you should stop further redirections and consider user to be authenticated, extract the token details and present it to the developer in the form of web authentication result dot response data. You can see rest of the code is pretty trivial to extract the claims that I am sending from my custom STS. And I have used proprietary mechanism and hard-coded the array variables here, but you can make it dynamic anytime. Now let's see how this application would behave when launched. When we click on Get User Info, Web Authentication Broker will be launched and it will take the user to Access Control Service through custom STS. Here we have configured different providers. I'm going to use Google. We are transferred to Google's website. Sign in. Google presents a warning about which application is trying to access which information. In this case, my name and email. I'll allow. And you can see the Windows Store application can see the email of the user who logged in as well as the name. Now let us see how we can integrate Active Directory using ADFS, Access Control Service, and Web Authentication Broker. We already have Access Control Service in place, configured to use Google, Yahoo, and Microsoft account. We will modify Access Control Service to also use ADFS, and we will show what changes do we need to do on ADFS to be able to use Access Control Service. Think of ADFS as your custom STS. In ADFS, user will provide credentials to your local ADFS, which we are seeing right now, and this will validate the user credentials against the local Active Directory. Since this is a claims provider, Access Control Service automatically becomes a relying party for ADFS. I can add Access Control Service as a relying party in ADFS by right-clicking and following the wizard, import data from a file, or you can also import the federation metadata by picking the URL from Access Control Service. I have already added Access Control Service in my ADFS, so I will skip this process. The moment you specify the federation metadata and add it, your Access Control Service would look something like this. Under Edit Claim Rules, I have configured this to send email and name claims from my Active Directory. When you'll start this from scratch, you'll add a rule. Select template of send LDAP claims as attribute. Give a friendly name. Select your Active Directory and specify that email should go as email, while let's say display name should go as name. You finish this and you will end up with this rule. This is all that is required on ADFS. On Access Control Service, we need to add ADFS as one of the identity providers. So we will go to Identity Providers, click on Add, and use the option of WS Federation Metadata. Click Next, give some friendly name like Active Directory, use a file. You can get the Federation Metadata of ADFS by going to ADFS machine and browsing the Federation Metadata URL of ADFS, which is fixed. And you can save this on your desktop or anywhere that you wish to, and browse it to upload to Access Control Service. Click on Save, and it should work fine. I have already added ADFS on Access Control Service, which you can see in the form of Active Directory. All I have to do is go to Relying Party and use my Relying Party, in fact, configure my Relying Party to start using Active Directory under Identity Providers, and then click on Save. Once I have done this, let's go to the rule group also and regenerate the rules because I have just now added Active Directory, and then save. Let's come back to Windows Store application and this time use ADFS for authentication. Here is our same Windows Store application. Let's try to run this. Click on Get User Info. And this time you can see that apart from the other online identity providers, it's also showing me Active Directory. Let's go to Active Directory. This is the login page offered by ADFS. You can customize that as well. Let me log in using my corporate credentials. Sign in, and it would come back to Windows Store application. And you can see again my email and name. So this was all about demonstration on how we can use Windows Store applications, Web Authentication Broker, along with Access Control Service to to use both against online providers like Yahoo, Microsoft account, Facebook, as well as your custom authentication provider like ADFS 2.0. Thank you very much.